ब्रिज कोर्स स्टैंडर्ड 10th सब्जेक्ट साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी पार्ट 1 एंड 2। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्टिविटी शीट नंबर 5 एंड 6 फ्रॉम पार्ट फर्स्ट एंड एक्टिविटी शीट नंबर 7 एंड 8 फ्रॉम पार्ट सेकेंड। स्टूडेंट्स, हियर वी गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्टिविटी नंबर 5 फ्रॉम पार्ट फर्स्ट। रेफरेंस फॉर दिस एक्टिविटी इज 9th स्टैंडर्ड साइंस टेक्सटबुक चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज अ करंट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। नाउ सी हियर, हियर पोटेंशियल एंड पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस। सो ऑब्जर्व दिस डायग्राम। सो जस्ट लाइक अ वॉटर, द फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज बिटवीन टू पॉइंट्स दैट डिपेंड्स ऑन द काइंड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक लेवल एट दोज पॉइंट्स। सो दिस लेवल इज कॉल्ड एज अ इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल। जसं इथं आपण वॉटरची लेवल दिसते, तर याच्यामध्ये जसे याच्यामध्ये 2 पॉइंट्स आहेत, तर तसंच काय इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज जो आहे तर तो पण काय असतो, त्याच्यामध्ये कुठल्या प्रकारची इलेक्ट्रिक लेवल आहे तर ती लेवल म्हणजेच काय इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेन्शियल असतं। सी हियर, अ पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज फ्लोज फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ द हायर पोटेन्शियल टू द पॉइंट ऑफ द लोअर पोटेन्शियल। And we have seen that earlier, the electricity flows due to the conduction in of the negatively charged electrons. तर आपल्याला माहित आहे की पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज हा काय होतो, दॅट फ्लोज फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ हायर पोटेन्शियल, जास्त पोटेन्शियलकडून कमी पोटेन्शियलकडे काय होतो, हा पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज फ्लो होतो। तर इथं आपल्याला माहिती आहे की इलेक्ट्रिसिटी फ्लो कशामुळे होते, सो दॅट इज द प्रेझेन्स ऑफ द निगेटिव्हली चार्ज्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दॅट फ्लोज फ्रॉम पॉइंट ऑफ द लोअर पोटेन्शियल टू द पॉइंट ऑफ हायर पोटेन्शियल। आता ही जे इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आहेत तर ते लोअर पोटेन्शियलकडून का होतात, हायर पोटेन्शियलकडे त्यांचा फ्लो असतो। सो इथे लाइटनिंग स्ट्राईक जेव्हा होतात, म्हणजे विजा चमकतात पडतात, तर तेव्हा काय होतं बघा, फ्लो ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ लोअर निगेटिव्ह पोटेन्शियल ऑन द क्लाउड्स टू द पॉइंट ऑफ द हायर, दॅट इज द झिरो पोटेन्शियल ऑन द अर्थ। वी शल स्टडी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेन्शियल इन हायर स्टँडर्ड ओनली। सी हियर, द डिफरन्स बिटवीन द व्हॅल्यूज ऑफ द पोटेन्शियल्स ऑफ द 2 पॉइंट A and B, दॅट इज कॉल एज अ पोटेन्शियल बिटवीन देम। आता इथं बघा, या डायग्राममध्ये आपण कंडक्टर ए जो आहे तर तो काय आहे, हायर पोटेन्शियल दॅन द कंडक्टर ऑफ बी। When these two are connected by the conducting wire, the potential difference is created between its two ends of and electrons will flow from B to A through the wire. This flow will continue until the two conductors, that are the A and B, having same potential, until their potential difference becomes zero. केव्हापर्यंत हे इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्लो होणार आहेत, जोपर्यंत या दोन्हीमध्ये काय असणार आहे, पोटेन्शियल डिफरन्स झिरो होत नाही तोपर्यंत हे इलेक्ट्रॉन जे आहेत तर ते फ्लो होत राहणार आहेत, आणि त्याच्यानंतर इलेक्ट्रॉनचा फ्लो जो आहे तर तो स्टॉप होणार आहे। नेक्स्ट सी हियर, डू यू नो स्मॉल व्हॅल्यूज ऑफ द पोटेन्शियल डिफरन्स इज गिवन हियर, दॅट आर एक्सप्रेस्ड इन द युनिट हियर। 1 mV, दॅट इक्वल्स टू द 10⁻³ V, and 1 μV is equal to 10⁻⁶ V. Here large values of the potential difference are given here, 1 kV, that equals to the 10⁻³ V, and 1 MV is equal to 10⁻⁶ V. Okay, now see the current flowing through the wire. Here some diagrams are given. Here see the random motion of the electron that are given in this diagram, and direction of the conventional electric current is shown in this diagram. See here, if a conducting wire is not connected to the cell, its free electrons move randomly in all directions in the space between the atoms. Okay, when we connect the ends of the wires to the two terminals of the cell, electric force act on the electrons being negatively charged, and they start moving from lower potential to the higher, that is from the negative to positive. Here see, from the negative to positive terminals of the cell, and that is shown in this figure. Due to this flow of this electron current, stars flow through the wire and this motion of the electron is irregular, but it is a definite one. Okay, and this one is a non-zero value of their average velocity. So this is a motion of the electrons after applying the potential difference between two ends of the wire, and thus the electrons moving from the negative to positive, that is a lower potential to the higher potential. Now see here, electric current, current is expressed is I is equal to Q upon T, the unit of this charge. SI unit is the coulomb and current expressed in the ampere. One charge of one electron is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. 1 ampere is equal to the current is said to the flow in the conductor if the 1 coulomb charge flows through the every second, that is the A is equal to 1 A is equal to 1 C, that is 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb upon 1 second. Now see here, Ohm's law. What is the Ohm's law? Here the current flows through the wire, that is the I, potential difference, that is a V, and we can obtain from law of that given by the German scientist George Simon Ohm. If the physical state of the conductor remains constant, the current I flowing through it is directly proportional to the potential difference V between its two ends. So here I means current is directly proportional to the V means a potential difference. So I is equal to K V, because the K is a constant of proportionality, and therefore I into 1 upon K, K V, K comes here and comes to the numerator, denominator place, is equal to V. So I is equal to 1 upon K is equal to V. So 1 upon K, that is the resistance of the conductor, and here therefore 1 upon K, that is the R, I into R. So current into resistance of the conductor, that is the potential difference. So hence V is equal to I R, that is the R is equal to V upon I. This is a Ohm's law. Here see, potential difference and the current is measured in the volts and amperes, and the unit of resistance is called as a ohm, and it is indicated by this symbol. So here this is a ohm. Therefore 1 volt upon 1 ampere is equal to 1 ohm. So resistance of 1 ohm, if 1 ampere current flows through the conductor, then 1 volt potential difference is applied between its ends, then the resistance of the conductor is 1 ohm. Now see here, electric circuit. Here circuit is given, it has different things. Electric cell, resistance is given here, voltmeter which is parallel in the resistance, then ammeter that is connected in the series. So here in this, ammeter is used to measure the current and voltmeter is measured to potential difference between two ends of the resistance. Voltmeter has very high resistance, only one small current flows through it. So here some diagrams are given. Observe this, point out the mistakes in above diagram, and here why are pulses in figure B, C, D below not lightning? Give reason for that. B, C and D does not lightning. So what is the mistake here? That is identified here also. See here, system of resistors and effective resistance. If resistors of two end component having given amount of the resistance between its two ends, the several electric devices and number of resistors are connected together in a different way. Here the Ohm's law is applicable for such connected series. Now see the resistors in series. So what is the resistors in series? See here, diagram is given. When here in this diagram, ends of the three resistors are connected so that they flow one after the other in a single line. These resistors are said to call as a connected in the series. Sir, such arrangement of the same current flows through each resistors, and the value of current I, that is the potential difference, that is the V between potential between these two points C and D, that is the V. Three resistors R1, R2 and R3, these are connected in the series in the circuit, and if V1, V2 and V3, these are the potential difference between every resistors, that is R1, R2 and R3, then V is equal to V plus, means potential, total potential difference V is equal to the potential difference between R1, here two ends of the R1, here V2 means two ends of the R2, and V3 means two ends of the R3. So RS, that is the S for series, it is the effective resistance between C and D here, and according to the Ohm's law, V is equal to I into S. S for resistance in series. So V1 is equal to I into R1, V2 is equal to I into R2, and V3 is equal to I into R3. So substitute all these values in equation 1 here, see. So V is equal to what is? V1 is I R1, then V2 is equal to IR2, and V3 is equal to IR3. So the resistors in series is equal to, so I get cancelled here because here we call as a common I. So I cancelled. So RS, so resistors in series, that equals to R1, R2, and if N resistors are connected, then this is like that. Now see here, resistors in parallel. These are said to be connected in the parallel when their ends are connected at the both sides. So that is shown in this figure like that. So here shows the three resistors R1, R2 and R3. These are connected and these are parallel, and they parallel between the point C and D here. So V is the potential difference between the C and D, and that is the common. Here let the I1, I2 and I3, that are the currents which are flowing through R1, R2 and R3. Then the total current is equal to I is equal to total current between these two points, that equals to I1, I2 and I3. So let the RP, that is the parallel resistor in parallel, so by the effective resistance between C and D according to the Ohm's law here, see. I is equal to V upon IP. Similarly, I1 is equal to V upon R1, I2 is equal to V upon R2, and I3 is equal to V upon R3. And substituting value of these in the equation, first we have here I upon RP is equal to I upon R1 plus I upon R2 plus I upon R3. And here, when these are resistors are connected in N number, then the equation becomes like that. So see here, we stop here. This is the activity number 5. Now we are going to discuss about the next activity number 6, that is the work and energy of the second chapter. Here observe these all pictures. In which of these pictures above has a work be done? So when we say work is done, when the force applied on the object causes the displacement of the object, then we call it there work is done. Work is equal to force into displacement. Now see here, the units of work is given. Work is equal to force into displacement. SI unit of the force is N, and displacement is meter, and thus unit of the force is Newton meter, that is called as a joule. So 1 joule is equal to 1 Newton into 1 meter. So J is equal to N into M. In CGS system, unit of the force is dyne, and displacement has a unit centimeter, and therefore dyne centimeter, that called as a erg. अर्क इज इक्वल टू डाइन इंटू सेंटीमीटर. सो वॉट इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द जूल एंड अर्क सी हियर. वर्क इज इक्वल टू फोर्स इंटू डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सो वन जूल इज इक्वल टू न्यूटन इंटू मीटर. सो वन जूल इज इक्वल टू 10^5 डाइन इंटू 10^2 सेंटीमीटर, दैट इक्वल्स टू 10^7 डाइन सेंटीमीटर. सो वन जूल इज इक्वल टू 10^7 अर्ग्स. देन वॉट इज पॉजिटिव एंड निगेटिव एंड जीरो वर्क सी हियर. सो वेन द फोर्स एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट आर इन द सेम डायरेक्शन द वर्क डन बाय द फोर्स इज पॉजिटिव. वेन द फोर्स एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट आर इन अ अपोजिट डायरेक्शन सो द वर्क डन बाय द फोर्स इज निगेटिव. एंड वेन द अप्लाइड फोर्स डज नॉट कॉज एनी डिस्प्लेसमेंट. वेन द फोर्स एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट आर परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर द वर्क इज सेड बाय द जीरो. Now see what is energy. The capacity of body to perform the work is called as the energy. The units of the work and energy are the same, and that are the SI system, that is the joule, and in CJ system, that is the erg. Now here see, so here's the energy which an object has because of its motion, that is called as the kinetic energy. The work done by the force to displace stationary object through the distance is the kinetic energy gained by the object, and therefore kinetic energy is equal to work done on the object. Now see what is the potential energy. The energy stored in the object because of its specific state or the position is called as the potential energy. Here the expression of the potential energy, that is W is equal to mgh. So m is a mass, h is a height, and g is a gravitational force. Now see here transformation of the energy. Energy can be transferred from one type to the another type. So examples are here given. In this example, electric energy, that is converted into heat energy, and vice versa. Then sound energy, chemical energy, light energy, mechanical energy, etc. See here what is the law of conservation of the energy. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be converted from one form into another, and thus the total amount of energy in the universe remains as a constant. This is the law of conservation of the energy. Now see what is the free fall. If we release an object from the height, it is pulled towards the earth because of its gravitational force, and object falling solely under the influence of the gravitational force is said to be in a free fall or the falling freely. So that one is the free fall. When the object is falling towards the earth in the influence of the gravitational force, so that is a free fall. Now see here power. What is power? See here power is a rate at which work is done. So power is equal to work upon time, that is a P is equal to W upon T. Here in SI system work is joule, and unit of power is a J upon S, that is a joule upon second. Here in industrial sector it is used to measure as a horsepower, that is 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. The unit of the energy for commercial use is a kilowatt hour. So here see, so 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 × 10^6 joule, and electricity used for the domestic purpose, it is measured in a units of kilowatt hours, that equals to the 1 unit. So this is about the activity number 6. Now we are going to discuss about the exercise from the activity 5. First question, see, point out the mistakes in the figure. So here, so these are the figures. find out the mistakes from all these figures. Now see, next question is all electric. Question 2 is, why are the bulbs in figure B, C, D not lighting up? So again here the figure is on the page number 35. See here, all in this C, B, C and D does not lighting up. Why? Question is here, why are the bulbs in figure B, C, D below not lighting up? Then question 3a, all electric appliances are connected by which type of connections from the figure? So figure on the page number 44, exercise question 3c. This one is the figure. Write down the all the electric appliances are connected in which type of connections. Now is all appliances have same potential difference? तर याच्यामध्ये प्रत्येक अप्लायन्समध्ये सेम पोटेन्शियल डिफरन्स असतो का सांगायचं या फिगरमध्ये. क्वेश्चन 3 इज विल द करंट फ्लोज थ्रू ऑल अप्लायन्सेस इज सेम. या याच्यामध्ये असणारा जो काय या डायग्राममध्ये असणारा काय आहे पोटेन्शियल डिफरन्स जो आहे तर तो काय आहे सेम आहे का हे सांगायचं आहे. विल द करंट फ्लोज थ्रू ऑल अप्लायन्सेस इज सेम. And D question is by which method are the appliances connected in house? Ha questions answers le jay. Now activity sheet number 6. First question, name any four forms of the energy which are found in your house. Question 2, write the name of one house appliance in which electrical energy converted into light and heat energy. Question 3, make a list of electrical appliances of your house and write the transformation of the energy. Conservations lehaycha ahe tithe energy che. Question 4, write two examples of each potential energy and kinetic energy che don examples lehaycha. So this is about the activity sheet number 6. Now here we going to discuss about the activity number 7 from the part 2. Reference for this activity is 9th standard science textbook chapter number 15, that is life processes in living organisms. So today's concept or topic is the coordination in human beings. In human, see here nervous control is there. So nervous control that plays an important role in the empowering the body cells with the ability to respond the impulses. Here all these control and coordination brought about with the help of the special type of the cells that are called as the nerve cells or neurons. Okay, so neurons, what is the structure of this neuron is see here. So here dendrites, nucleus, cell body and axon is present here. So all these part is called as the cell body and here this one part is called as the axon. Here myelinated sheath is present, node of Ranvier is present here and here axon terminal is present. Special type of the cell which conduct impulses from one place to the another, that is called as the neurons. Neurons are the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. Neurons काय आहे structural आणि functional unit आहे nervous system चे. So this is one is the largest cell in the human body. ही काय आहे पहा largest cell आहे. So here nerve cells have ability to generate and conduct the electrochemical impulses. Okay, then next see here. The cells that supports the nerve cells and helps in the functioning are called as a neuroglia. Je cells kya kartat ya nerve cells na help kartat cell support de kartat, so that are the neuroglia cells. Here see how that transformation, that information get transferred from one nerve to another is given. Here see or information of the surrounding that is collected by the ends of the dendrites and neurons. The chemical processes begins to those ends. Electric impulses are generated which are conducted from dendrites to the cell. Dendrite kon ka hota cell kade conduct kele jatat and to body from the cell to the axon and from the axon to its terminal. These impulses are then to the transfer from nerve cells to the next. आता याच्यामध्ये डेंड्राइट जे आहेत डेंड्राइट्सकडून इथं बघा डेंड्राइट्सकडून काय होतात इथं इम्पल्स येतो ॲक्झॉनमधून काय होतात ॲक्झॉन टर्मिनलकडे आणि ॲक्झॉन टर्मिनलकडून सेलच्या बॉडी सेलपर्यंत हे इम्पल्सेस कॅरी आउट केले जातात. इम्पल्सेस दॅट रिचेस टू द टर्मिनल ऑफ द ॲक्झॉन दॅट स्टिम्युलेट्स द नर्व सेल्स अँड दे सिक्रीट द सर्टन केमिकल. दीज केमिकल्स पास थ्रू द मायन्यूटेस्ट स्पेस हियर सी. आता इथं काय करतात हे सिक्रेशन सिक्रेट करतात स्टिम्युलेशन देतात हे नर्व सेल्स सिक्रेशन सिक्रेट करण्यासाठी आणि इथं एका विशिष्ट प्रकारचं केमिकल जे आहे तर ते सिक्रेट केलं जातं. याच्यामध्ये काय असतो मायन्यूट स्पेस असतो इट इज कॉल्ड द सिनॅप्स. सो बिटवीन टू ॲडजस्टंट न्यूरॉन्स जनरेट द इम्पल्स अँड टेंडर्स ऑफ द नेक्स्ट न्यूरॉन. इन दिस वे इम्पल्स आर कंडक्टेड इन द बॉडी अँड दीज इम्पल्सेस आर फायनली कन्व्हेड बाय द नर्व सेल टू द मसल सेलपर्यंत. हे काय होतात इम्पल्सेस जाऊन पोचतात. त्याच्यानंतर नेक्स्ट बघा ही मुवमेंट कशी होते ॲक्शन कशी केली जाते. सो दॅट मुवमेंट ब्रॉट अबाउट द बॉडी मस्क्युलर टिश्यूज आर इन द सिक्वेन्स. द मुवमेंट ऑफ द मसल सेल आर इसेन्शियल टू ब्रिंग अबाउट एनी ॲक्टिव्हिटी. आता काय होतं बघा सेल्स दॅट कॉन्ट्रॅक्ट टू चेंज देअर शेप मुवमेंट ऑकर्स ॲट द सेल्युलर लेवल. मसल सेल्स हॅव द ॲबिलिटी टू चेंज देअर शेप ड्यू टू द स्पेशल टाईप ऑफ प्रोटीन्स. इथं आता मुवमेंट होण्यासाठी मसल सेल्सची काय होतं त्याच्या शेपमध्ये किंवा त्याचं काय होतो चेंज होत असतो त्यांची ॲबिलिटी जी आहे तर ती काय होते चेंज होते आणि हे स्पेशल टाईपच्या प्रोटीन्समुळे हे होत असतं. आणि दस वी कॅन से दॅट द नर्वस सिस्टीम कन्सिस्ट ऑफ द वेल ऑर्गनाइज्ड नेटवर्क ऑफ द नर्व विच कॅन कंडक्ट द इन्फॉर्मेशन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इम्पल्सेस फ्रॉम वन पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी टू द अनादर पार्ट. नाव सी हियर टाईप्स ऑफ द नर्व सेल्स सेन्सरी न्यूरॉन्स दॅट आर द कंडक्ट इम्पल्सेस फ्रॉम सेन्सरी ऑर्गन्स टू द ब्रेन अँड द स्पायनल कॉर्ड. म्हणजे सगळीकडून हे काय होतात ब्रेनकडे येतात. मोटर न्यूरॉन्स जे आहेत त्यांच्यामध्ये कंडक्शन कसं होतं बघा इम्पल्सेसचं फ्रॉम द ब्रेन टू द स्पायनल कॉर्ड टू द इफेक्ट ऑर ऑर्गन्स लाईक द मसल्स अँड ग्लँड्स. आणि असोसिएशन न्यूरॉन्स आहेत विच आर असोसिएटेड टू इच अदर. दीज परफॉर्म द फंक्शन ऑफ द इंटिग्रेशन इन द नर्वस सिस्टीम. यांच्यामध्ये दोन्हीमधलं काय होतं इंटिग्रेशन हे केलं जातं. सो हियर सी ह्युमन नर्वस सिस्टीम कॅन बी डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री डिफरंट पार्ट्स सेंट्रल पेरिफेरल अँड ॲटोनॉमिक. सो दिस इज अबाउट द ॲक्टिव्हिटी नंबर 7. Now, next activity C, 8th activity. Here the central nervous system is consists in this 8th activity. So, the main parts are brain and spinal cords. Here the structure of the brain is given here. Brain is a main controlling part of the nervous system and it is safely located in the cranial cavity. Then spinal cord that is protected by the vertebral column. म्हणजे ब्रेन जो आहे तर तो क्रॅनियल कॅव्हिटीमध्ये आणि स्पायनल कॉर्ड जो आहे तर तो व्हर्टिब्रल कॉलममध्ये सेफ आणि प्रोटेक्टेड असतो. याच्यामध्ये जे स्पेस आहे बिटवीन द डेलिकेट सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टीम इट्स अ बोनी कवरिंग आर प्रोटेक्टिव्ह लेअर्स कॉल्ड ॲज द मेनिंजेस. तर मेनिंग्स असतात हे याला मेनिंजेस असतात आणि याच्यामध्ये काय असतं हे प्रोटेक्टिव्ह लेअर्स आहेत. कॅव्हिटीज ज्या आहेत ज्याच्यामध्ये प्रेझेंट असणाऱ्या वेगवेगळ्या पार्ट्समध्ये ब्रेनच्या आणि त्याला व्हेंट्रिकल्स असं म्हटलं जातं. तसंच जो स्पायनल कॉर्डमध्ये जे काही ट्युब्युलर कॅव्हिटी आहे सो दॅट इज अ सेंट्रल कॅनाल. व्हेंट्रिकल्स आणि सेंट्रल कॅनाल जे आहे आणि त्याच्यामध्ये ब्रेनमध्ये असणारी जी स्पेस आहे मेनिंग्समध्ये तर त्याच्यामध्ये दॅट इज फिल्ड विथ द सेरेब्रो स्पायनल फ्ल्यूड. Now see here brain, cerebrum, then cerebellum and spinal cord, medulla oblongata, these are the main parts of the brain. Here see, Here see functions of the left brain. What are the analytical thinking, logical thinking, language, science and mathematics? That is the function of the left brain. And the holistic thinking, then intuition, creativity, art, music, that is the function of the right brain. Here cerebrum, that is the largest part. These are hemispheres that are joined to each other with the help of the turf fibers that are called as the nerve tracts. It occupies 2/3 part of the brain. Then cerebellum, that is the smaller part of the brain situated below the cerebellum. Okay. Then medulla oblongata, this is the hindmost part of the brain, and there are 2 triangular swollen structure called as the pyramids on the upper side of the medulla oblongata. Now see here, spinal cord is a part of the central nervous system and it is held within the vertebral column, and it is a slightly thick but gradually tapers towards the end, and there is a thread like fibrous structure at the end that is called as the phylum terminale. Here now see the functions of different parts of the brain is given. Cerebrum, that control the voluntary movements, concentration, planning, decision making, memory, intelligence, intellectual activities, that is the functions of cerebrum. Cerebellum has coordination of the voluntary movements, maintaining body balance, etc. And medulla oblongata, that controls of the involuntary activities like the beating of the heart, then blood circulation, breathing, sneezing, coughing, salivation, that is the function of the medulla oblongata. Spinal cord has a function of the conduction of the impulses from the skin towards the brain. It also conducts the impulse from the brain to the muscles and glands, and it also functions the center for the coordination of the reflex action. So this is about the activity number 8. Now see the questions, exercise of the activity 7. Complete this chart. Human nervous system divided into 3 different parts. Label this diagram. Diagram of the nerve cell. Then answer in one sentence special type of cells which conduct the impulses from the one place to another in the body, that is called as what? See right here. Dash dash is the largest cell in the human body. Write the name. The cells that support the nerve cells and help in their functions are called as a dash dash. Now questions of the activity 8. Identify the parts shown in the figure and write the function. Hakayaga part cerebrum cha part ahe. Tache kay karayche name lihayche ani function lihayche ahe. Spinal cord cha name lihayche ani function lihayche. Complete this chart. 4 parts जे human brain चे आहेत ते लिहायचे आणि त्याचे functions लिहायचे तिथं. Then click on the part of the brain that is working while performing the following actions. तर कुठला पार्ट इथं वर्क करतोय ते लिहायचं. सानिया रिसायटिंग द टेबल्स पाडी म्हणत आहे. Then अद्वैत इज एन्जॉयिंग प्लेइंग द पियानो. लेफ्ट ब्रेन वर्क करते का राईट ब्रेन ते लिहायचं. जोहान इज कॉम्पोजिंग पोएम व्हाइल सिटिंग इन हिज गार्डन. याच्यामध्ये लेफ्ट काय राईट ब्रेन ते लिहायचं आहे. इन्स्पेक्टर फोर्थ वन इज इन्स्पेक्टर स्टार्टेड द इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन बेस्ड ऑन द इव्हिडन्स फाउंड ॲट द स्पॉट. लेफ्ट ब्रेन वर्क करतो का राईट ते लिहायचं. फोर्थ क्वेश्चन ऑब्झर्व मॉडेल ऑफ ब्रेन अवेलेबल इन द लॅबोरेटरी अँड स्टडी द ब्रेन अँड इट्स फंक्शन्स. So this is about this activity number 8.